Welcome back to the Crypto Bud channel, everyone. My name is Josh, and right now, Ethereum is running into critical support while Bitcoin is potentially repeating history, which I'll talk about in just a moment, so definitely stick around. First of all, starting off on the four-day Bitcoin chart, and right now, as of recording this video, the price of Bitcoin is technically still within the larger multi-month long bullish trend, as I've been saying since the beginning of this year, because obviously, as of right now, the price of Bitcoin is still forming significant higher lows and higher highs here on the four-day time frame, on the larger time frames. And on top of that, if you're looking at the super trend indicator, at least as of right now, this is still currently sitting in the green, indicating a larger bullish trend. And the invalidation level for this larger bullish trend based on the super trend indicator is sitting at around 25,000. And so what that means is if we see a strong confirmed break below 25K with at least a four-day candle close or ideally a weekly candle close back below 25K, then that would actually signal a trend reversal in this larger trend, talking about the super trend indicator. So once again, at least for now, while the price of Bitcoin is still holding above that level and still holding above this previous low close to 25K, technically we're still within a larger bullish trend despite the current shorter term pullback. But with that being said, it is important to point out that here on the 4-day time frame, there is actually a bearish divergence currently playing out, because as you can see right here, we do have higher highs confirmed in the 4-day candle closes in the price action, while also confirming lower highs in the 4-day Bitcoin RSI. And now, believe it or not, this is not the first time this has happened throughout this bullish trend. For example, we saw this happen with these two previous highs just here. Obviously, we saw higher highs in the price action while also seeing slightly lower highs in the 4-day Bitcoin RSI. And the outcome of that previous bearish divergence here on the 4-day time frame was simply a large pullback in the price of Bitcoin that lasted for around 1 to 2 months or so. But once again, even though we saw that shorter term bearish trend or pullback, whatever you want to call it, over 1 to 2 months, that still did not actually invalidate the larger multi-month long bullish trend. So once again, in the somewhat shorter term here, relative to these timeframes, we're looking slightly more bearish in the shorter term due to these bearish divergences playing out. But technically, we have not yet invalidated the larger bullish trend, because it is obviously possible to experience short-term bearish price action within a larger bullish trend, just like how we can experience short-term bullish price action within a larger bearish trend. But anyway, if you zoom into the daily Bitcoin chart, as I've been saying almost every day over the last 2 weeks or so, we obviously have an active bearish divergence here on the daily time frame, which is still currently playing out. And so once again, as I've been saying on the channel, we should not really be expecting any significant bullish momentum in the short term. And instead, we're likely going to see either some choppy sideways price action or some slight bearish price action, which has been playing out as expected here on this daily time frame. And considering the fact that we have not yet seen any invalidation signals in this previous bearish divergence, like for example, the daily RSI is still currently trending to the downside, when you consider that fact, I would still not be expecting any significant bullish momentum, at least in the shorter term. And now, speaking of the daily Bitcoin RSI, obviously, as of right now, as I just said, this is still trending to the downside. But with that being said, if this continues for much longer, then very soon we could potentially start to enter into oversold territories. And historically speaking, when the daily Bitcoin RSI enters into oversold territories, that is usually a time where the price is getting very close to some sort of low and we're due to see a significant bounce, kind of like what we saw back here. But once again, as of right now, the daily Bitcoin RSI is not yet in oversold territories, which technically means we still do have some room to the downside. And now, if you're looking at the daily Bitcoin MACD, as of right now, this is still currently looking more bearish than bullish. But with that being said, it is not showing a lot of momentum, which technically means we should not really be expecting a massive quick crash to the downside like that. And instead, we're likely going to see, once again, either some choppy sideways price action, if not a slight overnight pullback, pretty much like what we've seen over the last 1 to 2 weeks as expected. And now if you zoom into the 8-hour Bitcoin chart, taking a look at the Fibonacci retracement tool from swing low to swing high, we have the 38.2% Fibonacci level of support sitting at around 28.9K. And as of right now, at the time of recording this video, the price of Bitcoin is testing that level of support and in fact, potentially breaking to the downside. But we have not yet seen an 8-hour candle close well below that support level, at least not yet. And so technically speaking, for now, that is still the support to pay attention to. But if we see a proper confirmed break with candle closes back below 28.9K, then in that case, it's possible we could move down towards the 50% retracement level sitting at around 28,000 to 28.1K. And if that level does not hold up, then next we have the important golden pocket area of support in between 27,000 to 27.2K. And now just staying on the 8-hour Bitcoin chart right now, as of recording this video, a possible bullish divergence is forming in the somewhat shorter term here on the 8-hour time frame, because as of right now, the price of Bitcoin is technically forming lower lows in the candle closes while also forming higher lows in the 8-hour Bitcoin RSI. But it is important to understand that as of right now, this potential bullish divergence is not yet active, because as of right now, we have not yet actually cemented this higher low in place in the RSI with candle closes back in the green. So basically, in order to actually confirm this bullish divergence, we need to see at least a couple of candle closes confirm in the green on the 8-hour time frame to actually confirm this higher low in place in the RSI. Because otherwise, if the price continues a little lower over the coming hours, over the coming day, then in that case, it's possible the RSI simply continues lower into a lower low. And obviously, in that case, there's no bullish divergence. So this is just something to pay attention to while it is potentially forming. And if it does end up confirming with those candle closes confirming in the green, then it's possible Bitcoin could be repeating history like some of these other times where we obviously confirmed previous bullish divergences here on the 8-hour Bitcoin chart. But remember, we still have the larger bearish divergence active on the daily time frame. So basically, if the bullish divergence confirms on the 8-hour chart, once again, that would only likely lead to a slight relief. But overall, as of right now, we're still currently within a shorter term bearish trend or correction or whatever you want to call it within a larger bullish trend. And now, just before getting into some other important Bitcoin and Ethereum charts, first quickly reminding you that the World Series of Trading is officially open for registration and it actually starts in around 1 week from now. And this year, there is a total prize pool of up to 8 million USDT, a brand new Lamborghini Huracan, and multiple Rolex watches up for grabs. And in this massive trading competition, I am hosting an official Crypto World team, which you can join if you want to. And basically how it works is if you join the Crypto World team and the team places well in the competition, then you could potentially win a share in this massive $8 million prize pool split between the team members. And basically the more people that join our team, the better our chances are at actually placing well in the competition. So if you trade crypto anyway, you might as well check this out. And I'll make sure to leave a link to this page right here where you can join the Crypto World team in the description down below and in the pinned comment. In fact, it'll be the first link down below this video. But anyway, now getting into some other Bitcoin charts, taking a look at the 2-hour Bitcoin chart. And right now, as of recording this video, the price of Bitcoin has nearly completed this previous bear flag pattern. Because once again, as I've been saying since all the way back up here, we do have a bearish flag pattern, which confirmed with a break below this previous line of support, now acting as new resistance, sitting at around 29.7K. And from the moment we confirmed break below that level, that activated a technical price target to the downside, sitting at around 28,500, close to 28.6K. And obviously, as of right now, the price of Bitcoin has gotten very close to that technical price target. And once again, as I've been saying recently on the channel, technically speaking, that bearish price target is still currently in play. It is an active price target because we have not yet seen an invalidation of this previous bear flag pattern, because we have not yet seen a confirmed breakout back above this invalidation level, once again at around 29.7K. So at least for now, we're still technically looking more bearish than bullish in the short term, But once again, we have limited momentum, as I said here on the daily time frame. And now, if you zoom into the 1 hour Bitcoin chart, I talked about this possible symmetrical triangle pattern in my last video, which did have an initial breakout to the upside. But obviously, as I mentioned in my last video, the invalidation level for that breakout was simply a break back below around 29.3K. And so the moment we confirmed a break back below 29.3K, that actually invalidated the breakout to the upside altogether. And obviously, we still ideally needed to see more confirmation, like for example, a new higher high above this previous high, which did not actually happen. And so ultimately, that resulted in this breakout actually failing and breaking back below this level, which once again invalidated the breakout altogether. So we do not have any bullish price targets as of right now in the short term. And so once again, as of right now, we are still currently looking more bearish than bullish when you're talking about the shorter term, that is. But anyway, now getting into the Ethereum part of this video, this is on the daily ETH to US dollar chart. And right now, the price of ETH is running into this important area of support, sitting in between around 1770 to 1820. And obviously, as you can see right here over the last 1 to 2 months, and also back here during May, this historically has been significant support for the price of ETH this year so far. And so essentially, if we actually saw a confirmed break back below that area, obviously that would be a fairly strong bearish signal on the daily time frame. And in that case, the next important area of support is sitting in between around 1650 to 1.7K. And now, if you're looking at the daily Ethereum price oscillators right now, these are still looking relatively neutral, with the RSI potentially starting to flip a little bit more bearish as it is now forming a new lower low. But with that being said, if you're looking at the daily Ethereum MACD, this is still showing relatively low momentum, which basically means we should not exactly expect a significant move on the chart. And instead, we're still likely going to see relatively mild price action in the shorter term on the daily time frame, like what we've seen over the last 1 week or so, as expected. And now, if you zoom into the 6 hour ETH to US dollar chart, once again, in the somewhat shorter term here, we're technically looking more bearish than bullish for now. And this has been the case since we saw a confirmed break below this ascending line of support, as I mentioned on the channel back then. And as of right now, this line is currently sitting close to 1920 and should now be acting as new resistance. And as for other levels of support and resistance, staying on the 6 hour time frame, looking at the Fibonacci retracement tool. And right now, as of recording this video, the price of ETH is running into this important 50% retracement level, sitting at around 1820 to 1830, which has also historically been important support over the last 1 to 2 months. And also, it's possible that the price of ETH could be forming a giant head and shoulders pattern right now. But with that being said, we don't exactly have a strong right shoulder for a possible head and shoulders pattern, because really the shoulders need to be around the same size. And so basically, in order to complete any head and shoulders pattern possibly forming, we ideally need to form a proper right shoulder close to the same size as the left shoulder. So as of right now, we don't really have an active head and shoulders pattern here on this time frame. But with that being said, if we see a confirmed break below around 1820, either way, that would still at least be a shorter term bearish signal. And in that case, if we actually see a confirmed break below that level, then we would likely see a move down towards the important golden pocket area of support in between around 1760 to 1770 approximately. And as for resistance, we should find some resistance at around 1870 to 1880, like what we've seen over the last 1 to 2 days around this Fibonacci level. But if we saw a confirmed breakout back above around 1880, then in that case, we also have this resistance at around 1920. And above that, we also have some resistance at around 1930. And now, if you want to know how to make a lot of money very easily in the crypto market, no matter if the price is going to the upside, to the downside, or simply chopping around sideways, then make sure to watch these videos popping up right here on your screen. The video in the top left shows you how to make money if the price is bullish or bearish using AI, and the video in the bottom left shows you how you can easily profit from choppy sideways price action. But anyway, that's everything that I have to say for today. I really hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you all in the next video.